lots of land under starry skies above. Don't fence me in. Let me ride through the wide open country that I love. Don't fence me in. Let me be by myself in the evening breeze and listen to the murmur of the cottonwood trees. Send me off forever.
She only joined a couple of years ago, but I knew I felt something for her. Only yesterday did I realize what it was. It was that undeniable, inexcusable, irreversible love that I felt for her. It was that love that I would not let go of, no matter what.
So, this must be the club. Can any of you ladies tell me where to sign up?
Her eyes would still be locked, but no, thanks to him, this is when the problems all started.
Robert, who's that?
I don't know, but he's trouble.
Good to see that you're interested in playing the game, Andrew. It's not often that we get young ones down at the club. To us, 22 is still quite young.
Yeah, as per my grandfather's will, I have to be an active member of this club for at least 3 months so I can get my inheritance.
We can get you to stay longer. We've always wanted people your age to play the game. Would you like me to teach you how to play?
Yeah, that'd be great.
You have a go.
All right.
That was great, Andrew. One of the best shots I've seen all day. You're a natural.
Well done.
That was
really
fantastic,
well done.
Andrew.
Shot, Andrew.
We'll see you around the club more often.
Ah, it was nothing. Who can show me where to get some lunch?
Yes,
ladies?
We can. We'll go.
I've got your stuff, Andrew.
Over the next 3 weeks, Andrew went from great shots to even greater shots, and from humble to arrogant at the same time. Word of his skill began to spread to all the women in the club.
Too sexy for my love, too sexy for my love, love's going to leave me.
Skill came arrogance, so much so that he decided to completely disregard one of his most important duties to the club as a member, and with that bred a hatred for him that our club had never seen.
And so we have agreed. On Monday and Wednesday afternoons we will serve a slice of Thelma's delightful date and walnut loaf with afternoon tea. Now, our next is Beryl. I think she has something very important to say.
Hey, Beryl.
Thank you, Beryl. Friends, members and lawn bowlers alike, I have some grave news.
Oh. Oh.
But don't worry, nobody has died yet.
Oh.
Last week, myself and Ernie, who is currently in charge of all rostering duties, came up to Andrew and explained to him his responsibilities as a member of the club. This all-important duty of making sandwiches for the ladies' afternoon tea every Thursday. It is our sacred duty to make to be part of these rosters and to make these sandwiches. If the rostered members don't do it, who will?
Good question.
And that is why it has come as such a shock that Andrew did not turn up to make these sandwiches.
Oh, really? Wow.
We all loved Andrew as our own bowler, and we all thought he was a great bowler. But how can he be a great bowler and a member of this club if he doesn't even bother to make the bloody sandwiches?
But what are we going to do about it?
We are going to do the only thing we can. We have to get rid of him. He is an embarrassment to our club and to us for teaching him how to bowl. We have to make sure he never comes back by whatever means necessary.
Everybody silence, please. This issue has to be agreed upon by all of us today. Linda, you have grown particularly close to this pest. Will you do what is needed?
I liked Andrew. I really did. But he has disgraced us in a way that it is simply unacceptable. We have to get rid of him, no matter what.
Then it is agreed. Beryl, I'm putting you in charge of the Eliminating Andrew Committee. See that it gets done.
And so Beryl and her newfound members of the Eliminating Andrew Committee met at morning tea. I was there, of course.
Oh, give me land, lots of land.
We talked through different strategies and ideas all morning. In the end, Rosemary had a great one. She thought we could hit him in the head as he bends down to pick up his bowls. Another idea we had was to load his tea with laxatives, making him run to the toilet all the time to embarrass him enough to force him to leave the club.
What he did to those girls was shocking. They were so hungry.
Don't worry, he'll get his just desserts soon enough. We'll go with Rosemary's idea first, and if that doesn't work, we'll put laxatives in his drink.
That's it.
Okay.
Well, I think we're done.
Okay. All right. Decided. Okay. Let's go. And so it started.
This one should get him.
Oh my gosh! You were
get
right.
Up. Get up.
That was only the beginning of our favours.
This will fix him. You've been running in the toilet in no time.
And gaze at the moon till I lose my senses, and I can't look at harbors, and I can't stand fences.
Oh, Rosemary, I think you've got my tea. See you, Robert. I'll be back tomorrow. I think I'm finally getting the hang of this wacky game. Make sure you have an umbrella. Looks like a storm's brewing.
Thanks. That's great. Just great. Yes, thank you. I'll make sure I bring one. That was it. All of our ideas were spent. We hit the wall. It was time to finally accept that he would be here forever. He would be at our club for the rest of our lives. Send me off forever, but I ask you please.
Well, I guess God has solved our problem for us.
Oh, I guess that's a spot of luck. That's earned us some of Thelma's date and walnut life.
Yes.
Robert, would you mind escorting me to the club?
I'd love to.
I want to ride to the ridge where the west commences. And gaze at the moon till I lose my senses. And I can't look at hobbles, and I can't stand fences. Don't fence me in, no.
Papa, don't you fence me in.